Hello, AntsCanada here once again, bringing you another random and helpful tutorial on ants. Now, we've created a tutorial on catching your own queens during nuptial flight. We've created a tutorial on how to create a test tube setup for them. And now, this tutorial is about what to do when the first worker ecloses. It's a very exciting event, especially if you are first-time ant-keeping parents, I guess. it's really exciting. You've essentially watched your queen over the several weeks lay her eggs, care for the young, the larvae turn into pupae, and the painstaking waiting period, so hard, I know, don't worry. And one day you realize you have your first worker ant. So, we've had several messages asking us what to do when you have, your first worker. It's very exciting, because it's essentially the beginning of a complete colony. So, essentially, you want to stay calm. pop the champagne, do what you want, celebrate when you first have your workers, but you want to stay calm. You still want to keep the colony relatively undisturbed. If you're keeping them in a test tube setup, you don't have to touch them or feed them right away. What I like to do is I like to wait until two or three workers have eclosed. I'm assuming that there are other pupae developing. What I tend to do is I usually wait about a week before I do anything, and it's fine. The ants don't starve to death, they don't do anything. But what that does, what the week does, is it allows the workers, the newly eclosed workers, to fully harden. Their exoskeleton is still relatively soft when they first eclose. I found if you try feeding the ants 2 or 3 days after they eclose, oftentimes they will reject food, even liquid food for that matter. I suspect that it's because maybe their mouth parts or even their internal parts are still, I guess, hardening or developing, or who knows. It seems that they tend to reject food for the first few days. They don't starve, so don't worry about that. Now, after a week, what I'll do is I'll feed them liquid food. I'll give them a drop of honey. Which is almost always readily accepted. Of course, the queen will also benefit from that honey, because if you were keeping a fully claustral species of ant, she would have been fasting that whole period, so she's depending on these first workers to give her sustenance. Then, if it still seems like the ants are restless, they're pulling at the cotton, trying to get out, after a few days of having their honey, I'll proceed to give them a cricket leg or something small, a small piece of insect or protein source, that they can have. If you have access to fruit flies, by all means, use those. Now, try not to use flies from outside, because there's the danger of pesticides, which you don't want to have to deal with, especially this being a young colony. Eventually, within 2 weeks, the colony should be feeding healthily, for the most part again. Ants are, there's so many different kinds of ants, they all have different needs, and even within the same species, every colony can have a behavior of their own, have a sort of mastermind of their own. So, essentially, you just kind of have to read them. By the time you have a nice group of workers going, that's usually a good time to move them from the test tube to a formicarium. Now, if you've raised them right off the bat in a formicarium, like any of our AntsCanada formicaria, then you essentially don't have to worry because your whole setup will already be done. You can attach the formicarium to an outworld already, and you know, when the ants are ready, they'll venture out into the outworld to go eat. And if you like, you can even deposit a drop of honey inside the formicarium for them to drink, you know. And so, yeah, in terms of water, you want to make sure their setup always has, you know, moisture. If it's a test tube setup, allow them to move into a new setup if the test tube setup that they're in is moldy or dry. And if they're in a formicarium, of course, be sure to properly hydrate the formicarium and place a test tube full of water into the outworld. So that's essentially it. You know, if your ants aren't eating in the first few days, like I said, don't worry. The ants can last a few days without food for a little while. That's all. And good luck on all your ants that you're keeping. For those of you who have captured queen DLHs this year, congratulations. And for the first time ant keepers, congratulations. You know, it's certainly an exciting thing, an exciting process to watch. And I know a lot of you right now are at the stage where your queens are founding colonies right now. They're in the initial founding stage, which is great. And I know most of us out there will have hibernation coming up, and it's definitely another phase that our colonies will be moving into very soon. We'll be creating more videos on that later. As hibernation season approaches. Thanks again. Spread the ant love. Take care, guys. Thanks for the support. Bye.